Take it easy. Yeah, we got some ball gag going up in here.
Mm-hmm. I can't even talk because you're cracking me up. We're going to show y'all what some Jerusalem artichoke looks like. Oh. And if he don't take my head off. And Jerusalem artichoke grows on the side of the road here in western Kentucky and probably lots of other places. I'll show a picture here. So we moved 3 pieces of it to our property a couple of years ago so that we would have some on our property to use as a survival food. It can be eaten like potatoes. It has tubers in the ground. I'll show those here. It is lower in calories and carbs than potatoes. It is still a little high in carbs if you are on any kind of low carb diet like I am. So I don't eat a lot of them because of the low carb diet. It has 26 carbs per cup and no starch. So if you are diabetic and you want something with no starch, similar to potatoes, but no starch. So there you go.
And if you're in a survival situation, you ain't gonna worry about carbs or calories.
That's
or
true.
Anything.
As a survival food, it is awesome. It's an awesome survival food. It has potassium. It has lots of potassium, which is great. It tastes to me like a kind of a cross between a potato and a water chestnut. Maybe depending on how it's fixed. So you can, like I said, eat it raw. You can cut it up, clean it off good. The little tubers you can clean off good and slice up and put straight into a salad. Or you can cook them any way you would potatoes. If they're cooked very long, they get mushy. So mashed potatoes out of them would probably be the best as far as that goes.
When they become mashed potatoes.
All right, we're going to show you our little spread of them where we just like 2 years ago brought 3 plants home from the side of the road so that we would have it growing here. We did put it off in the corner because it is, it does spread. It spreads heavily. So here in the back corner of our property, there's our house over there. And there's our chicken coop and shed over there. And way down here in a corner, we have brought the Jerusalem artichoke in. And like I said, it's getting crowded, so it really needs to be divided. It needs to be divided up and spread out some. There is our bunch of Jerusalem artichoke. Goes kind of back in there a little piece. We will, you can see how crowded that is in there. And we are this fall going to dig a bunch of that up and spread it all out here in this spot. This is where I used to have an herb garden, but it was wasn't a great place for an herb garden because it is kind of shaded a little bit. Now, this Jerusalem artichoke will grow good in just about anywhere. It grows on the side of the road wild here and will grow just about anywhere. That bunch there came from 3 plants 2 years ago. So in 2 years, 3 plants have done that. So I'm going to get a close up of the flower. It's very pretty. It is in the sunflower family, but not the sun, you know, not the seeds. It doesn't have the seeds like a sunflower, but it is in that kind of family along with the aster family. Just my opinion, it would make a great survival food. So if you dug up a few of these on the side of the road and moved them to your property, you would have a substitute for potatoes in a survival SHTF situation. That's what we have done with them. Because, like I said, I do low-carb diet, so I really don't use them a lot. We have used them a few times just to try them out. They can cause flatulence, especially if you eat very much of it. Also, Jerusalem artichoke has inulin fiber, which is good for gut health and helps lower your blood sugar for type 2 diabetes. And also the potassium and iron found in Jerusalem artichoke helps lower blood pressure and helps reduce the bad effects of sodium for people with high blood pressure. So you might consider taking you a few pieces of a few plants of this Jerusalem artichoke off the side of the road or field or wherever you can find it at in your area. Take a few of them home if you have enough room to let it spread, because it will definitely spread. Or if you don't have room, you can be sure that you dig it up each year and plant a few back and propagate it properly so that it doesn't take over. And in the description below, I will add some other information and a couple of recipes. So be sure you look below in the description and find those the information and a couple of recipes down there. Now, the numbers for this plant are for one cup of the tubers has 110 calories, 3 grams of protein, 26 carbs, and 10 grams of fiber. So it does have some benefits, but it also is a little high on the carb side and the calorie side too, maybe. So anyway, but it is lower than potatoes. So again, it is a good substitute for potatoes. Just don't eat too much of it or you will get flatulence. Now, you can add this tuber, wash it up good, and slice it up and add it to a salad. Or you can add it to a soup toward the end for a little crunch. Don't overcook it or it will get mushy, as I said before. So there you go. That's what I found out about Jerusalem artichoke. We hadn't used it a whole lot. We did move it here for, like I said, for a survival food. Some of the information that I have found out about this plant was with the help of Patty at the Tinkerer's Wife, and we appreciate her help in finding out more about this Jerusalem artichoke. Y'all give us a thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and watch us on Friday nights at 7 p.m. Central Time for more foraging.
Just going home.
Drive right. Stop. Drive right. Oh, no.
I'm a professional driver.
Golf cart out of control.